From the Chattahoochee Tech Studio, welcome to the Marietta Daily Journal Podcast. Today is Tuesday, January 10th, and happy 78th birthday to Rod Stewart.
Wake up, Maggie, I think I got something to say to you.
I'm Dan Ratcliffe, and here are your top stories presented by Engineered Solutions of Georgia. A man was hospitalized after a single car accident. Lifeline Animal Project is looking for homes for dogs during a canine flu outbreak. And Wheeler basketball came up short against Sierra Canyon in Los Angeles. We'll have all this and more coming up on the Marietta Daily Journal Podcast.
Engineered Solutions is your locally owned and operated commercial and residential foundation company that specializes in foundation repair, basement waterproofing, and crawl space encapsulation.
I'm consumer investigator Dale Cardwell. I've done the research already, so you don't have to.
678-ESOG now.
A man was hospitalized Sunday night after crashing into a tree off Cobb Parkway in Marietta. According to the Cobb County Police Department, the man, who has not been identified, was driving a white Nissan Altima north on Cobb Parkway near the intersection with Progressive Way. The car left the roadway and crashed into a tree. The driver was trapped in the vehicle and seriously injured. After being extricated from the car, he was taken to Wellstar Kennestone Hospital. Anyone with information about the crash is asked to call police. A Kennesaw woman was killed Saturday after being hit by a car as she was walking a dog. Veronica Miller was struck by a car and killed around 9 a.m. Saturday. According to the police, Miller was walking the dog and crossing Wooten Lake Road at the intersection with Glenlake Parkway when she was struck. Miller was crossing from the north side to the south side of Wooten Lake Road and was struck by a blue 1999 BMW 328i, according to police. The driver, a 23-year-old Kennesaw man, was not injured. Anyone with information about the incident is asked to call police. There was no way around it. A Sierra Canyon boys team, known for its flash, for its highlights, for the celebrity that follows, was going to have to get gritty Saturday night, assistant coach Chris Howe said. The Trailblazers were taking on nationally ranked Wheeler, a team that Howe said simply had dudes. Two of those dudes, in fact, were playing at their future stomping grounds, senior Isaiah Collier and Arrington Page, a pair of Southern California signees. But after Sierra Canyon fell behind by double digits early, its move on a string defense overwhelmed the prized recruits and Wheeler in a 66-55 win, perhaps the Trailblazers' best of the season. The team down by 8 at halftime, Sierra Canyon staff challenged senior Ashton Hardaway, coach Andre Chevalier said after the game, and Hardaway, son of former NBA All-Star Penny Hardaway and a Memphis commit, responded with perhaps his best all-around half as a Trailblazer, getting aggressive on the glass and banging down low with Page. It was his range, though, that propelled him to 18 points and a pair of massive third-quarter threes to pull Sierra Canyon back into the game. Hardaway barking at any Wheeler defender within earshot while backpedaling down the floor. And after a quiet first half, Bronny James continued to show an improved sense of the moment in his senior year, detonating for 17 fourth-quarter points. Collier finished with 17 points but was held by James, Isaiah Elohim, and a horde of Trailblazers wing defenders to 5-for-16 shooting. Page finished with just 8 points and 7 rebounds.
Well, you're my dog now, Snoopy. I'll show you to your new home.
Before all dogs go to heaven, many dogs go to shelters. At an adoption event held by Lifeline Animal Project and Best Friends in Atlanta, a number of dogs and one cat were adopted out of the shelter and foster system to become family pets. The dogs were gathered, though socially distanced, on leashes outside the office of Best Friends in Atlanta off of South Cobb Drive near Dobbins Air Reserve Base. Most of them were taken to the event by their foster owners. An outbreak of canine flu in Fulton and DeKalb counties is part of the reason why the shelter system in metro Atlanta is stressed. According to Vickers, the Lifeline shelters are diverting all new intakes to foster homes instead of shelters to prevent them from potentially coming into contact with contagious shelter dogs. Most dogs recover from canine influenza within 2 to 3 weeks, according to the CDC, though the virus sometimes leads to more severe illness. Lifeline is still adopting out dogs that are testing positive for canine flu to people who don't have other dogs. Foster families without other dogs can also help keep infected dogs isolated from shelters. Fostering for any amount of time, even over a single weekend, can help dogs find permanent homes because it provides more information to potential adopters about how dog behaves in a home environment. Both organizations vaccinate, microchip, and either spay or neuter their animals before they are adopted out. For more, visit lifelineanimal.org and bestfriends.org/Atlanta.
Unknown error. Every time I think my business is on track, I get these computer issues that shut me down for a day.
Ever since my business partnered with Click IT of Marietta, I don't even worry about those types of things. They're local, they have 20 years experience, and specialize in helping small businesses just like mine and yours.
Do they handle hardware and software?
Hardware, software, malware, you name it. Just tell them when and where, and they will be there. Visit them online at marietta.clickitcomputers.com or give them a call at 678-202-4600. Instead of submitting a support ticket, call Marietta Clickit.
You deserve better than your bank. Better service, better rates, better solutions. If you live or work in Cobb County, now is the perfect time to make the switch to Credit Union of Georgia. The better way to bank. Since 1960, Credit Union of Georgia has been providing Northwest Georgia with financial solutions that make sense for your home, business, and family. As a homegrown, not-for-profit cooperative, our members are our mission. Not only will you get the best loan rates, you'll get personalized customer service from people who understand your needs. Plus, Credit Union of Georgia provides real convenience with a network of more than 30,000 accessible ATMs and branch locations across the country. Of course, there's also 5 locations right here in Cobb County. Ready to see how much better your banking can be with Credit Union of Georgia? Become a member today or apply for a loan online by visiting cuofga.org. Credit Union of Georgia, the better way to bank.
Students and teachers alike lined the streets Friday afternoon to give a warm welcome to Marietta High's boys and girls cross-country teams who swept the state championships last year. 2022 was the second time in 3 years Marietta claimed both Class 7A titles, doing so in 2020 as well. Buses carrying the champions processed through West Marietta, ending at the high school.
It's a wonderful day for pie. You can ask all the birds in the sky, and they'll tell you real sweet with a musical tweet.
It's a wonderful day for pie.
For pie.
People and businesses are responding to a break-in at a local eatery with donations and gifts. 2 days before Christmas, thieves smashed the front door of Pie Bar Marietta near Marietta Square around 5 a.m. and left with a cash drawer and a safe from the bakery. Owner Lauren Bolden discovered the break-in when she arrived at the store that morning. Pie Bar's locations in Marietta and Woodstock have seen a response from the community in the weeks since the break-in. Woodstock City Church bought tacos for the staff's lunch, while Woodstock Mayor Michael Caldwell asked people to donate money to the business on his Facebook page. Since the break-in, Pie Bar Marietta added some security measures, and it's operated without accepting cash. Bolden said the business is considering going cashless at the Woodstock location as well. Bolden wasn't sure whether the business had recouped the cost of the stolen money and the door replacement yet, but she said the support helped the business get through a difficult day. On December 23rd, the day of the robbery, several hundred customers were supposed to pick up their Christmas orders from Pie Bar Marietta. Those pies had moved to the original store, and all the associated customers had to be told their pies were now in Woodstock. Vivian Gamble of Ackworth, the general manager for both locations, says she thinks the majority of people who have come in lately have heard about the crime and are coming in to make sure everything's okay and support the business.
Are you struggling to find the right home in these tough markets? Hi. I'm Jeffrey Drake of Drake Realty, with 7 offices across Metro Atlanta and 2 right here in Cobb County. The real estate market in Cobb County can be competitive. That's why you need a team on your side. My team of over 700 agents is one of the biggest in the county, and we have been turning dreams into realities for 28 years now. Next time you decide to buy or sell in Cobb, trust the team that knows the lay of the land. Visit us online at drakerealty.com.
Thanks again for listening to today's Marietta Daily Journal podcast. Did you know over 50% of Americans listen to podcasts weekly? Make sure you join us for our next episode and share this podcast on social media with your friends and family. You can add us to your Alexa Flash Briefing or Google Home Briefing, and be sure to like, follow, and subscribe wherever you get your podcasts. This podcast is a production of BG Ad Group. Darren Sutherland, Executive Director. Jacob Sutherland, Director. Matt Golden, News Director. Chin Ray Zhang, Director Producer. And Jason Gentarola, Audio Producer. All rights reserved.